with your new hires?
Great. I did everything that you and Chris suggested, and but I've run into a small snag.
Oh, what's your snag?
Most of my new developers don't know Rails.
Oh, well, just pair program with them.
There's just one of me.
Oh, that's right, and five of them. Well, have you considered mob programming?
That sounds dangerous. What's that?
Don't worry, it's not. In fact, why don't we cover the benefits of pair and mob programming in today's build tip?
That sounds cool.
Welcome to Build, brought to you by Pivotal Tracker. I'm your host, Purnima Vijayashankar. In the last Build episode, I shared some tips for onboarding new hires. In today's episode, we're going to dive in and give you some more tips around how you can onboard engineers, get them up to speed on a code base or a programming language they may not be familiar with really quickly. And to help us out, Chris Jobst is back. You'll recall Chris is a senior software engineer at Pivotal Labs. Thanks for joining us again, Chris.
It's great to be back, Purnima. Thanks again for having me.
Wonderful. So let's dive right in.
Yeah.
What's pair programming?
Pairing is when you have two people sitting at one computer. We often have two monitors and two keyboards and two mice, and they're literally working on the same code at the same time.
So that's gotta be really time consuming to have two people doing the exact same task at the same time. What's the benefit?
It sounds really daunting, but it's actually very efficient.
Mm-hmm.
You're basically doing code review 100% of the time.
Okay.
And you get to refactor together.
Mm-hmm.
So you avoid a lot of these common things that you'll see in other code bases.
Okay. So maybe for some folks that don't know code reviews or refactoring, maybe we could share what those are as well.
Sure. Oftentimes, before something gets committed or accepted into the code base,
mm-hmm.
you'll have somebody review it
okay.
and make suggestions. And then the original committer has to go back and change it, and then it goes back to the code review and gets accepted.
Okay.
That's a sort of feedback loop that we completely avoid with pair programming.
Mm-hmm. And with refactoring?
Refactoring is simply where you take code and change the implementation without changing the functionality
okay.
to improve the readability and maintainability of the code.
So in pairing, since you've got two sets of eyes kind of checking each other's work, probably moves a lot faster as a result.
I think so. There's code review going on. You're refactoring together, you're always talking about the best way to solve a problem,
mm-hmm.
and if you don't know what to do, instead of having to go ask someone or stop an email, you've got your pair right there.
Which is probably the benefit for new hires.
Absolutely.
So for audience out there who may be new to pair programming, how can they get started?
Well, you need one computer mm-hmm. and another monitor, and you need two keyboards and mice. Most people already have that on hand.
Yeah, and are there any rules, I'm guessing?
Absolutely. The biggest one is have empathy
mm-hmm.
and just be kind to your pair. You're both working together. It's pretty intimate, but it's a lot of fun too.
Now, are both people writing code at the exact same time?
No. So you kind of decide who's going to drive at a certain time and
okay.
type on the keyboard, and the other person will navigate and maybe suggest, hey, what if we went over here and did this thing?
So it's kind of like a pilot, co-pilot, and then maybe you trade off.
Yeah, that's a great way of describing it.
Awesome. There are some situations where you can't pair program, like in Ronan's case where he's got five engineering hires and they don't know Rails, so how can you work with a bigger group?
Well, you can do what's called mobbing.
Okay.
You get one computer mm-hmm. and often a TV screen or projector, and you have a bunch of people, five or more,
mm-hmm.
look at the code, and one person is typing, and you're kind of generally more teaching or gathering suggestions about how to best achieve a goal.
Got it. So I'm sure somebody who's looking on from the outside is going to be like, why are five people sitting around one machine and writing a single line of code? So what are some of the benefits? Why would we want to do this?
As you pointed out, it's great for onboarding new people.
Okay.
And what you'll have is people asking questions. Oftentimes, mm-hmm. they'll ask a question somebody else didn't think of, but it's a question that they need answered.
Got it. And I'm sure it also helps with the bus factor, right? Like everyone's going to kind of know something or know the same thing.
Definitely. You want everybody on the same page. You want them all knowing how the code works. And if you've got a bunch of new people,
mm-hmm.
it's actually more time consuming to go and teach every person individually than to get them in a room and help them learn from each other and from the person who's the expert.
Got it. This is a great primer on pairing and mobbing. For audiences out there who maybe want to dive a little deeper, do you have recommendations on resources?
Definitely. There are two great books that I love, Extreme Programming and Extreme Programming Explained, both by Kent Beck. I recommend the former for engineers. It really talks about these practices and the process in more detail. Extreme Programming Explained is a great resource for PMs. It talks about it on a higher level and how the whole project can benefit.
Thanks for sharing these great resources and tips, Chris. I know our audience is going to get a lot out of this.
Thank you for having me. I'm a huge proponent of pair programming.
So, for all of you out there, Chris and I want to know, have you done pair or mob programming with your teams as you onboard new hires? And if so, what are the benefits you've experienced? Let us know in the comments below. That's it for today's episode of Build. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to receive more episodes like today's. And special thanks to our sponsor, Pivotal Tracker, for their help in producing this episode. Ciao for now. This episode of Build is brought to you by our sponsor, Pivotal Tracker.